greeting of the day to everybody. I am Mamta Sagar from Department of Bioinformatics. I will teach you today what are natural resources. Okay. So before going into the details, we will first discuss what are natural resources. So natural resources are our treasures that we use in our daily lives. Okay, so these are the important component of the environment which are necessary for all the human beings, for all the creatures that are living on the earth. So in the introductory concept of the environment, you have studied about what is environment, what are the different components. So these components are atmosphere, like air makes atmosphere component, water, that means hydrosphere component, land, that means lithosphere component, okay, and there is one more component that is called biosphere. Biosphere component include living beings like animals, plants, all the types of creature that perform vital activities like respirations. Okay. So all the living beings comes in the biosphere component. So biosphere components is the main component of the environment, that is human and other animals or plants. They play an important role in the environment. So all the living beings of the biosphere component needs a good environment to live in the particular conditions. So we have different creatures on the earth, like different kind of animal, different kind of plant. So that is due to the environment, because of the differences in the climate, variation in the climate. We have different varieties of apples, different varieties of fruits, vegetables. Okay, so that is only because of their environment is different. In Himachal Pradesh, we have different kind of atmosphere. In Kashmir, we have different kind of atmosphere. In Rajasthan, we have the hot atmosphere. So it depends on the climate and environment, how the plants will grow in that environment. And it also impact human activities also, like the skin color, or there are some there may be some changes in the appearance of the human, but all the vital activities, that is same. Okay, so the rate of the it may affect the RBC productions, or that we will discuss in the detail in the coming lectures. But today we are going to study what are the different resources. So within the environment, we have studied what are the different components like land, air, water, okay, and biosphere component. So these were the four components. So apart from the bio, we should also include the biosphere. So these four components give rise to the natural resources. Because if we talk about the land resources, from the land we get so many things that is necessary for our living. Land provide the shelter, it also provide the food, because plants are grown on the land. So in that way it also provides us the food. So we have pond, seas, but that it only exists on the earth or land. So we need the land. So all the aquatic animals lives in the water. So water part is also necessary from the hydrosphere component, from the aquatic component. Different kind of animals and including human also, so they take their food from the aquatic systems. So that is also used as a food resources, like aquatic systems, terrestrial system. In the terrestrial system, we have the different kind of ecosystem like forest, plants. From the plants, we get the different kind of vegetables, from different kind of fruits. So that is all resources, that is all our resources, like food resources. From the land we also get the minerals. So land is the treasure of the minerals, we get the minerals from, we extract the minerals from the land. But human is unable to extract the mineral, directly extract the minerals from the land. So plant, in our food requirement, we also need the minerals or metallic component. But we are unable, our system is not like that. We cannot eat the iron or minerals directly. So plant helps in that. Plants extract the minerals from the land. And that is not the plant alone cannot perform this function. They also take the help of other organisms, that is called microorganism. So there is a various way, or there is a food chain that exists within the to make the interaction among these four components. So food chain is the necessary part that makes the interaction among the four components. So these four components give rise to the different kind of natural resources. So we will discuss what are the different kind of natural resources. In the hydrosphere atmosphere component, we also have the different kind of the resources. What is the most important one is the air, the fresh air that in which you are breathing. Without the oxygen, you will die. If you don't get the oxygen for more than 1 or 2 minutes or 3 minutes, okay? So you will get die. So in the absence of oxygen, in the corona time, you may have seen the several people are dying because of lack of oxygen, because their lungs or their system is unable to take up the oxygen. They need more oxygen, but they are unable to respire properly. So you can see, you can think how the oxygen is important. So that is also our treasure. So we should take care of all these resources, because these are our treasure, and this is equivalent to money also. How much production we do in the India, that is called money, that is converted into the money. Because if we do not have the any production on the earth, so we cannot purchase anything. By the money you cannot purchase anything if nothing will be produced. So this product, this natural resources are equivalent to money. So we should take care of these resources. So we are food resources, water resources. In the water resources, we have the seafood, aquatic food like sea fish. Fishes are used as a, so these are the different. So what are the problem associated with the main problem associated with the natural resources is unequal consumption. We are not using it equally, because some of the people need more, but they get very few, they get the less resources. As some of the persons do not need, some of the person need the more resources, but they consume very less. So major part of the natural resources are consumed in the developed world. In the developed countries, we have there is very low population, but they get the most of the natural resources. They used to consume most of the resources. Although natural resources, the South Asian countries and developing countries have the more number of natural resources, but we are doing the business for them. We used to export our resources to them. So what is the problem? So that we will also discuss what is the problem behind this. The developing nations also overuse many resources because of their greater human population. So because we have the large human populations, we also use the greater number of the resources. So why there is unequal consumption in the developed countries? They consume the large number of resources also. But what is the difference? What is the problem here? Actually, we do not have any control on our population. So population should be controlled to regulate everything. Because we have the large population, so we are doing the production also. Still the people are hungry in our country, and there is so much variation that we have the poor and rich people in the India, and there is no. In India also, and in all the South Asian countries, in all the developing countries, we have so much variation. So this doesn't happen in the developed countries. because so what is the difference between developed countries and undeveloped countries? So there is the difference of the population. They have control on their population, but we do not have any control. Like developing countries do not have any control on the human population. So this is the important, and this give rise to the unequal conjunctions, because they have more money, so they use to purchase our resources. The developed countries to purchase our resources. So this causes the unequal conjunction of the resources. Although we have the more number of resources within the area, but we have the greater population also. So the consumption of resources per capita of the developed is 50 times greater than in most developing countries. So you can think of why they are getting more resources. Like whatever product we produce within the India, so a developed country used to get the high quality of product, like tea, that you are the upper layer of the tea, the first layer that is produced as a tea, so that is exported to the developed countries, and you get the low quality of the tea that you are drinking in your daily life, that is of low quality. So good quality of the tea is exported to the developed country. So you can think of why there is the so too much difference. So advanced can, because we do not have any control, means we have the large population, so whatever we produce, so that becomes very low in our country. There is no sufficient for the large population. So first of all, we need to control the population. Advanced countries produce over 75% of the global industrial waste and greenhouse gases. So they are giving us the pollution, wastes, and we are dealing with that. Energy from fossil fuels. But they are aware, advanced countries are aware of the environmental problem. And there are some cases they used to send their waste to the India, like the electronic wastes. They used to send their waste to the India by the aeroplanes. Oh, it may also happen by the sea, through sea or Pacific Oceans. So energy from fossil fuels consumed in relatively much greater quantities in developed countries. Their per capita consumption of the food too is much greater, as well as their waste. So you can think of their producing more waste, and they're also participating in the reduction of waste. So the USA, for example, with just 4% of world population, consumes about 25% of the world resources. And producing the animal food for human consumption. So they require more land than the growing crops. So the countries that are highly dependent on non-vegetarian diet need much larger area for the pasture land than those people are mainly vegetarians. Actually, for animal-based food production, we need the more land. Okay. than the vegetarian productions, and there is the more consumption of the resources in the production of the animal food in comparison to the vegetarian food. So in the developed countries, they used to eat more non-vegetarian food than vegetarian food. So our natural resources can be compared with money in the bank. If we use it rapidly, the capital will be reduced to zero. So we should take care of our resources. Human development index that shows the growth of the human, and that is dependent. What are the main factors on which this index depends? These are increased longevity, okay, increased life jo hai aajkal increase ho chuki hai due to the advancement in the medical technology. Okay, so all the people are living the, means in comparison to the previous days, like before 20 years, 50 years, in comparison to those days, the longevity has been increased due to the advancement in the medical technology. So all the people used to live approximately 80 years, 70 to 80 years. So an increase in knowledge, so knowledge also increasing, knowledge is also increasing day by day. I should say information is increasing, not the knowledge. Information is, we have lot of information. So, but we should get the knowledge to use the information. This is correct. An enhancement of income. So, so income has been enhanced. So, knowledge, human development index is calculated by increased longevity, an increase in knowledge, and enhancement of income. So, these three things are considered when we calculate the human development index. By these three important factors, we can measure the how much growth we have done, human has done. These three together are known as the human development index. It means a source of supply, support, generally held in reserve, natural means, and ecosystem, not influenced by man. So our growth, so that is dependent upon the supply, support, generally held in the reserve, natural means. So this all happen in the nature. So that is not influenced by the man, because human causes the intervention in the natural ecosystem. If we do not disturb the natural ecosystem, there will be growth of that system. So the human also causing the problem to the ecosystem or the environment or our surrounding. What is environment? That is our surrounding. Natural resources can be defined as variety of goods and services provided by nature. So this is the definition. There are the four components. Each component has the provide the resources, natural resources, and these are the goods and services provided by nature which are necessary in our daily to daily life. Plants, animals, microbes, living. So in environment we have the two components, living component and non-living component. So living component is also can be used as a food, that also become the as good source of food. And air, water, soil, mineral, these are the climate, solar energy, these are the non-living part, and that also makes the environment, good environment. So these all are our resources, because from these components we use to get everything, whatever is necessary for our life. These things are, these components are necessary for the life, for microbes, animal and plants. They are essential for the fulfillment of physiological, social, economical, cultural needs. Because our culture is dependent on the, our physiological process is dependent on this. Like if the people are living in the cold area, they will have the fair color, fair skin color, or the okay, their physiological process may be a different variation. They will show the variation. So they will have the different kind of culture, social culture. So economy will be different, because economy is also dependent on that. What kind of atmosphere is there? In the Rajasthan we will have the different kind of economy. In the Chennai we will have the different kind of economy based on their plant production. Like the economy is based on the, like coconut is also the main thing there. So the culture dependent on the environment, because we develop the culture like that. In the desert, if the people are living in the desert, they used to wear the turban, okay, and they also used to close their mouth with the cloth, and their women also used to do the palla or parda, okay, due to the different kind of them. So culture dependent on that. So in the North India we have this culture ki parda karna hai ye sab. In the Arabian countries also we have this culture, okay, but in the South Asia, in Kerala, like you see, so they do not have this culture. So that all are dependent on the climate or environment. So culture is also dependent on environment. It is community. Resources are of two types, namely renewable, and now we'll discuss what are these renewable resources are, that can be renewable that we constantly get these resources, okay, and that will not be consumed. And non-renewable resources are the resources that will not be available in the future if we use the resources at the constant rate like we are using today. So we should use, what are these renewable resources? Are the plant products that can be, okay, oxygen you can get from the atmosphere, because this we get from the plants. So plants are there, they convert the carbon dioxide into oxygen, so they're renewable resources. Okay, what are non-renewable resources? Like petroleum, oil, diesel, these are the non-renewable resources. Natural resources which can be used but can be regenerated by natural processes if there is no intervention in the natural, like water, wood. So water is also recycled, there is a water cycle. So we used to drink the underground water, okay, that we take out with the help of the submersible pump or, okay. Water used to get evaporated by the pond or by the water land surface into the atmosphere during the summer hot. So evaporation rate is high. So when there is a very hot atmosphere, so water is changed into the vapor, then these vapors after the condensation they will come down to the earth in the form of rainfall, that is called precipitation. So now the water become the part of the river, oceans after rainfall, or the land. Some of the water get percolated to the ground. So in that way water get recycled, or that we can say this is a renewable resource. And there is no water scarcity on the earth because we have the 70% of water on the earth. Still we face the problem of the water scarcity in the different countries. So that is that means we do not have the proper water management. So the countries or the area that have the water scarcity, so we can provide, we should have the system so that we can provide the water to them, because there is no water scarcity on the global earth, so we should see it globally, and we should develop the system for the water management so that everybody can get the water. So the fresh water sources are very few, like the iceberg or underground water. So sea water we cannot drink, the pond water we can drink, underground water we can drink, but the sea water we cannot drink. That is the marine water, it contains the high mineral salts, not good for our health. What are non-renewable resources? Those which will be exhausted in the future if we continue to extract these without the thought for the subsequent generations. So what are these resources? Minerals, fossils, fuels. So that is very limited, the coal. So there is a long process. The underground dumped animals and plants that are dumped under the ground. So over it took thousands of crores of years to convert them into the oil. So there is a slower decomposition of the plants and large animals or large plants. So these resources are produced after a long period, slow decomposition, by the slow decomposition. So it took too many years, millions of years to convert the plants and those animals into the fossil fuels. So generally these are like in the old period there may be the dinosaurs, they were the large animals. So some of the animals may be the large in the size, so they have been dumped in the ground. So after the millions of years, so they have been converted into the minerals, fossil fuels. So it may happen in the So it is happening from the older time, older period. So this is the slow process, very slow process. So now that these resources are consumed in the higher rate, in the present day, we are using it at the higher rate or higher speed. So it may happen in the future, our future generation will face this problem. Different types of resources like forest, water, food, energy and land resources are. Okay. Now we will discuss in detail one by one. So that was the overall general introduction of the natural resources, renewable resources. So till now we have studied about the renewable, non-renewable resources. What are the resources? Okay. Natural resources. Forest, water, food, energy, land resources. Now we will discuss in the detail. So first of all, we will discuss about the forest. So today, we discuss about forest resources. A forest can be defined as biotic community predominant of trees, shrubs, any other woody vegetation in the closed canopy. So it is derived from the Latin forest, means outside. So forests are outside, in the far, like outside, they're far away from home, that is we call them forest. Okay, far away from home. So all the types of tree and shrubs, we call them the forest resources. So the biotic community. So India's forest cover is the 676,000 square kilometer. That is the 20.55 of geographic area. Scientists estimate that India should ideally have 33% of its land under forest. It should have. So today only we have the 12%. You can think it should have the 33%, but today we only have the 12%. So we need not only to protect our existing forest, so we should also increase our forest cover. So we should immediately stop the cutting down the trees, and we should do the plantation, more plantation, to grow the forest. We should not plant only the few trees and taking the snaps, taking the photos, the pictures to be published in the newspaper. We should do more plantation at a larger rate. We should develop the forest, or we should stop the deforestation immediately. We should stop cutting down the trees. Forest function, what are the first? Actually, we are cutting more trees, more number of trees, but we do the vraksharopan activity, vraksharopan. That is only for the publicity. Change will come when we will do it at the higher rate, like we should plant more number of trees, not only one, we should like 100 trees, 200 trees, 300 trees. Then only the change. This only can change the environment. Not the plantation of one plant. What the forest gives us, there are so many things. It provides protective and ameliorative functions, productive function, recreation and education. These are four types of functions. Protective means they are providing the food or shelter. Because the people living in the forest, they used to live in the home that is made up of wood. So they're providing the shelter to the human or animal creatures. Productive function, they're giving the product like vegetables, okay, food products. So we're dependent on the plants for our food, vegetarian food. Recreation, educational function. So plants, wherever we see the plant, we feel very good, no? There is a greenery, so we feel good in that kind of atmosphere. We used to get revived in our life. Whenever we have the disease, we can go to the, we are told by the doctor, you should go in the natural green atmosphere, okay, to get out of this disease. Development functions. So plants are used in the forest are used for the development functions also. Because our development is dependent on the forest, we get the resources by the plant, like the food resources. So they also play the important role in our development. We also export the plant product to the foreign country abroad. so by which we get the benefit. So it also play an important role in our development. So India is known for the rice production, like. So India get the second position in the rice production. So there are many more things that is for the tea production. It is also known as for the tea production. So there are so many products like coconut production in the South India, kali mirch, black pepper in the South India. This is also famous in the world. So this also play an important role in the development. So what is protective and ameliorative functions? Watershed protection, reducing the rate of surface run of water by increasing impact from the rain. So watershed protection. Okay. So if there is a flood, if we plant more number of the trees, there will be reduction in the rate of the flood. The flow will be decreased. The flow of the water will be decreased by the more number of trees. If we have more plants grown on the earth, there may be the slower. The flow of water gets slowed down. Preventing flash floods, soil erosion. So in that way, it will also reduce the soil erosion. Producing prolonged gradual runoff and thus safeguarding against drought. और इस तरह से in that way will not face the drought. सूखा नहीं पड़ेगा इस तरह से, ठीक है. So it also hold the water. In the floody area, what happen? The upper layer, that is fertile layer, humus is run off by the flood. And it goes from that one place to another place. So all the fertile land become barren by the flood. So it took 100 or thousands of years, okay, to come back in that conditions. So if there is a more number of plant, so they will be protect. और सूखा भी नहीं पड़ता है वहाँ पे. They also hold the water, necessary water. So these are the functions of the forest plant. Forest और जहाँ पे भी होंगे सब. Erosion control automatically happens, holding soil by preventing rain water from directly washing soil away. This is the same thing that we have discussed. Land bank, maintaining soil nutrition structure. So plant also play an important role in maintenance of the soil, because in the land bank we used to grow the plant so that the soil nutrients should be retained in the that structure. So that is the modern type of agriculture field, model agriculture field or land bank. And we used to do it to maintain the good soil quality. Atmospheric regulations, absorption of solar heat during the evapotranspiration. Maintaining carbon dioxide level for plant growth. So plant absorbs the solar heat during the evapotranspiration and evaporate the water into the atmosphere. Plant also absorbs the sun radiation. So in that way, they are reducing the heat of the earth. Maintaining the carbon dioxide level for plant growth, they used to take up carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, because in the presence of carbon dioxide, you will die. There is no oxygen. So they are taking up the carbon dioxide, and in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, they convert this carbon dioxide into oxygen. And oxygen is necessary for all of us, for all the creatures, for all the animals. So all the animals and plants, they breathe in the presence of oxygen. Bacteria also, some of the bacteria, aerobic bacteria, respire in the presence of oxygen. Maintaining the local climatic conditions. So the plants used to maintain, regulate the climatic conditions. If there is no plant, there may be कभी कभी वहाँ सूखा पड़ जाएगा, कभी वहाँ बाढ़ आ जाएगी, देर में भी तो डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम जो है. इफ देर इज अ प्रॉपर नंबर ऑफ बैलेंस ट्री, प्रॉपर बैलेंस नंबर ऑफ ट्रीज इन दैट एटमोसफियर, सो द क्लाइमेट विल बी रेगुलेटेड. लाइक इन राजस्थान वी डू नॉट हैव द ट्रीज, सो देर इज सो मच हॉट एनवायरमेंट बिकॉज ऑफ द क्लाइमेट. सो डिपेंड्स ऑन द क्लाइमेट कंडीशन ऑल्सो. सो क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन in turn dependent on the presence of trees. So we can change, somehow also it depends on the nature. It is natural process, the types of trees will be grown in particular kind of atmosphere, but we can maintain this also. If we want to maintain the atmosphere like the summer, like desert, like Rajasthan, if you want to maintain the good environment in the Rajasthan, we should plant more number of trees. But soil we can't change, so we can make the land bank there, so we can try to maintain. Lekin Rajasthan ki jo land hai wo Mewat mein bahut pathreeli hai, so in the Mewat we do not have this condition. So in the Mewat there is the harsh condition, it is very low water. So there is two part of the in the Rajasthan, Mewat and Mewar. So in the Mewat there is the pathetic condition, so people used to live in the low amount of the water. There we found the camels, so rats, they also used to live in the low amount of water, so they get adapted to that. Nagfani we have in the Rajasthan in desert. So plants maintain the climatic condition. We should plant. Anyhow, we should plant the trees there. But the soil structure, the type of the soil do not allow in all the cases. There may be the limiting factor also. Productive functions, local use, consumption of forest product by local people who collect it for the sustenance, food, gathering plant, fishing, hunting from the forest. So these are the productive function, because forest people dependent for their food on the forest product, food or other requirement, fodder for cattle also dependent on that, fuel, wood, charcoal for cooking, heating, posts for building homes in rural wilderness area. So you can see rural people and local people, tribal people, they are all dependent on the trees, totally they are dependent on the forest. And if there is the deforestation activities, first of all the tribal people, tribal population, the local peoples will get affected by that deforestation. But by the name of the urbanization, we are doing that, and we do not think about those people, those who are living near to those areas. We used to displace those people for the urbanizations. So why we need the more house? Because we do not have control on our population. We are making more. We need more house because we do not have the control on our population. We are facing this problem. We need the more house for their survival. So for that we use the agriculture land. So again we use the agriculture land. Now where we do the agriculture, we will cut down the tree, we will cut down the trees, we will do the deforestation, and we will develop the agriculture field there. So that's all due to the urbanization, due to the uncontrolled population. Okay, so the tribal population used to get affected, the local people get affected by these activities. So in turn, we also get affected. So this indirectly affects us, our atmosphere, environment, our oxygen, our air, that is all common. So we also get affected by that. Timber for household articles, construction fiber for weaving baskets. These are the types of product, ropes, nets, strings. So that is produced by the forest. So these are the different kind of business also, sericulture for silk. So this is the apiculture for rearing bees, for honey. Okay, so these are the different kind of products, food, plant products. So economy is also dependent on this. So we should not cut down the trees. if we cut down the trees, we should think what will happen in the future. In the future, we will not get these types of product. Medicinal product, medicines are necessary. All the medicines we get from the plant. But whenever we cut down the trees, whenever we do the deforestation for the urbanization, all the herbal plants, all the types of plants have been washed. So medicines are essential for us. Most of the product used for the consumptive purposes, those are the good source of income. But medicines play an important role. These are essential in different kind of disease. So nowadays we are consuming synthetic medicines. But semi-synthetic medicines are important one. That is derived from the natural plant. Minor forest product, anti-FPS. Minor forest products, there is fuel, wood, fruit, gum, fiber, which are collected and sold in local market as a source of income for forest dwellers. So these are the different kinds of products. So this all we get from the forest. Major timber extraction. We need the wood for the furniture, industrial use, for the paper production. Lignin is used. Lignin is found in the plant bark. Timber extraction done in the India by forest department, but illegal logging continues in many of the forests of India and the world. So, you can think of timber extraction is done by the forest department, but there is an illegal extraction. Recreational educational function, ecotourism. So plants are good. We feel good to see the plants in the nature. These are so many garden, like Mughal garden in the Delhi, or different kind of garden present all over the India. Different kind of zoological park, national park. So we used to go there to see the different kind of animal, different kind of the plant. But there are different kind of the diverse plants and diverse animals that you can see only in the national park and botanical garden. But nowadays, so many varieties have become disappeared from the nature, but they are only available in the national park or zoological park. You can't see them in the nature. So we should take care so that the diversity should be there. Different kind of flowers, different kind of good plants, flowering plants. If you want to see them in the future, you should take care of them. Development functions, employment functions, revenue. So it also play in development role, because our economy is dependent on the plants. So employment is also dependent on that. So in that way, this is that play a major part in the revenue collection. Ecological significance of forest, like it balances the carbon dioxide, oxygen level in the atmosphere that we have discussed already. Regulate earth temperature by hydrological by maintaining the water cycle. How the water goes up in the atmosphere in the summer. In the hot atmosphere, when the temperature is high, then it changes into vapor. Then vapors are condensed, and there is a rainfall. Okay. And from the land, it goes up in the atmosphere. This cycle. So this is called water cycle. Hydrocycle. Temperature is regulated. If the plant evaporates the water, that means their temperature will get down. Increase seepage, reduce runoff, losses, prevent growth. Seepage increased surface. Okay, and it reduces the surface runoff, means soil erosion. We have discussed already. Reduce soil erosion, root binding. because it due to the presence of forest, there is a minimum soil erosion. It prevents the siltation, reservoir, landslides नहीं होंगे, flood, बाढ़ आएगी तो पेड़ होंगे तो उसे रोक लेते हैं. Some of the plants are high rooted, बहुत गहरे तक वो नीचे जाते हैं. Their roots penetrate higher in the earth. So in that way they reduce the landslide. Litter helps in maintaining soil fertility, safeguarding birds, wild animal, organisms, solar radiation, rain. Because they also protect us from the solar radiation, dhoop se bachate hain. And birds, animals, they all used to get shelter on the trees. So they are the different function. So the plant also help us to maintain the diversity, because this provide the home to other animals. Forest is the home to other animals like rats, small animals, deer, lion, different kind of animals. So cash crop economy, raising cash crops for increased economy. This is another function, benefit, mining, increasing population. So the need also increase and utilize forest resources. So actually cause behind all the problems are for increase in the population. So this increase the forest utilization. If we want to use the more forest, we should grow the forest, we should maintain the forest. Then we should use it wisely. It should be controlled. It's not that we should not use the forest, we should use the forest, but there should be the limitation. So this lecture is prepared by the ICAR Environmental Study e-books. You can refer this book, see book. So these are the different kind of function that we have discussed today. So in this lecture we have discussed about the what are the natural resources, what are their different components that give rise to natural resources, what are the protective function, different kind of function played by the forest. So that was all about the natural resources. Still we need to study more about the forest resources. Okay, this is not over, so we will discuss more about the forest resources in our next lecture. Like deforestation is a main issue. What are the other issues like pollution or other issues that is associated, how we can keep control on the deforestation or other problem that is associated with the forest natural resources. So that's all the things we will discuss in the next lecture. Okay, so today we have discussed about the forest functions, what are the different kind of function played by the forest. Now lecture is over. Good day to all.